Our life is the expression of our inner potentialities. We project ourselves to the extent we know of our inner status. And there is much more to life than that which we are already living. Let us consider what more there is to life and what more can be lived than that we are living in the present. Certainly, it is wise to know the whole extent of an expression of our life and to try to bring it in all that we have been missing so far. We know if we drop a stone in a pond, the ripples begin to move, and they move over the whole pond, reaching all the extremities. One slight stir in any part of a pond stirs the whole pond, influences the entire field of water and its surroundings. Similarly, by every thought, word, and action, every individual is setting forth influence in his surroundings, and that influence is not restricted to any boundaries. It goes on and reaches every level of creation. Every individual, by his every thought, word, and action, shakes the entire universe. This is the status of an individual. One is connected with the whole universe by every little bit of his activity. An individual appears to be bound by the boundaries of home and the boundaries of his own body. But in reality, the subtle aspects of the individuality go to make universal existence. An individual is never an isolated individual. He is intimately interrelated with the whole cosmos. Even more than that, he shares the responsibility for the life of the whole cosmos. The entire universe lies in the individual. Cosmic existence lies in the existence of the individual. Cosmic life rests in the individual life, and the individual life extends to cosmic life. The individual and the cosmos are interdependent. Neither of them is independent of the other. Every move of the individual shakes the cosmos. The universe reacts to the individual action. Every individual has this power that shakes the universe and shakes and saves the gods and angels in heaven. Man has this strength that upholds the universe. The individual, by his every action, serves the universe. And the great power of nature is ready to serve the individual if the individual influences the universe for the progression of the process of evolution. By its very existence, the creation is set in motion to go on through the steps of evolution. If the action of the individual is in conformity with the purpose of creation and the purpose of evolution, then the individual serves the cosmic purpose of life, and all the great laws of nature readily serve the purpose of the individual. It is a simple and automatic process of give and take. As you sow, so shall you reap. When the individual behaves rightly, he improves, and by so doing, he contributes to the betterment of the entire universe. But when knowingly or unknowingly he behaves wrongly, he acts contrary to the process of evolution. The laws of nature begin to react against him. The individual receives back the result of his wrong actions. If we think right, speak good, and act truthfully, we receive the support of all the laws of nature, carrying out the process of evolution around us. Naturally, when we serve the government, we enjoy all the advantages of the laws of the government, because all the laws are to serve the individual interest. We as individuals have the influence over the whole universe, every one of us influences the entire universe by every little action we perform. Obviously, we do not perceive it, but at every moment, we are either supporting or damaging the entire universe. Better we forget not the great responsibility that we can do and undo the entire creation that breathes the life of God by the simple individual mistakes of ours. The wrong once done cannot be undone. It returns to us from all sides. Everything suffers for our wrongdoing, and we are made to suffer for the suffering of all. Thou shalt reap the consequences of thy doings is the fair policy of Mother Nature. She only wants her children to enjoy. But while enjoying the flowers in the garden of God, those who walk loosely falter and fall unduly. The joy of life is there. It depends on us whether we make use of our power and use it or lose it. Better we produce the influence of all harmony, and we will do this by virtue of our natural ability to think, speak, and act rightly. Our individuality will then command the power of the universe. Make use of the cosmic power of the individual law in favor of our desire, and use cosmic life energy for the health and great accomplishments in life. The unlimited source of cosmic life energy is at our disposal. We have only to begin to use it. The great cosmic intelligence lies at our disposal. We have only to connect our individual mind with the cosmic intelligence, with the universal mind, and gain all clarity of thinking and all success in activity, and live a life of eternal freedom on earth. The great possibility of our individual life contacting the universal cosmic life energy and intelligence is here at hand. Eternity lies in the present. Eternity always in the hands of the present. It only needs to be appreciated. The present holds the master key to unlock the treasures of eternity. Every moment of our life is supplemented with the eternity of the bygone past and that which awaits us in all the moments to come. Eternal existence of the unlimited cosmos is available to us for all power. Certainly, as we have seen, we are influencing the entire cosmic life, but somehow we are not making use of the great unlimited and vast resources of nature that are at all times available to us. We are always giving. Through every thought, word, and action, we are producing an influence in the cosmos. We are always giving. Certainly, we want to give out to our atmosphere all harmony, all peace, all happiness, all love, all serenity and grace, because this alone is useful and life-supporting. Certainly, we want to create a better life, healthier and more useful surroundings. Therefore, it is of vital importance that we should know where to receive this great life energy, greater happiness, greater intelligence, greater harmony, greater serenity and grace. Yes, there is a primal source of all happiness from which spreads all happiness that is found in the world. There is a primordial power of life energy from which all energy emanates. There is one primal source of serenity from which the serenity and peace spread in all creation. Let us find out where the source is of all these most desirable features of life. And having found out the source, let us try to contact it and be in a position to draw on unlimited amount of happiness and energy, intelligence, peace and grace for all good to ourselves and to our surroundings. We should know that the purpose of creation is expansion of happiness. From a seed grows the tree, from the atom develops the molecules, and the entire field of forms and phenomenal creation. The subtle strata of creation are at the root of the gross strata of nature. The subtlest stratum of life is at the root of all the different levels of life and living. And there is a level of life subtler than the subtlest, which is permeating all the subtle and gross levels of existence. And this subtler than the subtlest stratum of existence, this transcendental state of being, is the basis of all creation. This is the basis of all cosmic life, cosmic intelligence, cosmic energy. And here, at this level of the transcendental absolute being, dwells the cosmic law, which is responsible for all creation and evolution of life. It creates the innumerable laws of nature to carry the ceaseless activity of evolution of the entire cosmos. This cosmic law is such that in itself it never changes. It maintains forever the absolute status of the being, and maintaining the absolute status of the being gives rise to different laws of nature that conduct the process of creation and evolution, a process which continually goes on and on for all times, filling the phases of eternity, of time and space. Here is the eternal being secured by the eternal status of the never-changing cosmic law, which is the source of all creation, the basis of all cosmic intelligence, and the source of all energy, power and creativity. This is the ultimate source of all power. It lies in the field of the absolute transcendental existence, which is omnipresent. And as such, it lies within the heart of every one of us. This untapped source of power that lies within us has to be tapped, and cosmic life energy and intelligence has to be directly and consciously made a part and parcel of our life, and then our individual existence will be naturally supplemented by the cosmic life energy. Our individual mind will be supplemented by the unlimited power of the cosmic intelligence. Our happiness of this sensory level will be supplemented by the bliss of the eternal absolute being. The present creativity of our mind and the ability of our body will be strengthened and reinforced with the boundless energy of the absolute being. The health of both body and mind, and also the health of the surroundings, will be immeasurably improved. Efficiency will be immeasurably increased. By gaining control over the master switch of nature at the level of cosmic law, the natural laws governing the surroundings become favorable and begin to support the aspirations of our individual mind and the desires of our hearts. We as human beings, having such a perfected nervous system, have the ability to control the powers of nature. Make hay when the sun shines. Let us not lose the insight into life and the great possibilities that lie therein. And how do we utilize our ability to harness this cosmic life energy present within? Let us be careful that we do not delude ourselves and become lost in the maze of mystical concepts. For it is very easy to get lost in the wilderness of imaginations and lose the perspective of life. We belong to the realistic age of science. Let us be sure that all that we strive for and achieve remains realistic. Our age of scientific unfoldment does not give credence to anything shrouded in the garb of mysticism. Let us realize the absolute being through a scientific and systematic method of achievement, where every achievement will be supplemented by the personal experience. The way is simple, because the goal lies within us. We have only to dive within ourselves and consciously arrive at this stratum of the absolute existence. For that, we have only to bring our attention from the gross level of existence to the subtle levels of thinking and diving deep into the thought process, arrive at the subtle states of thinking. We transcend the subtlest state of thinking and consciously arrive at the source of thinking, which is the field of the being that lies beyond the subtlest phase of creation in the transcendental field of eternal being. This is how, by exploring deep within ourselves, by the method of transcendental deep meditation, we arrive to fathom the ocean of life energy present within ourselves and tap the power of cosmic intelligence and bring the force of eternity and cosmic energy in the present, right here and now, and be what we want to be, what we ought to be, and what we deserve to be. Certainly in our lives, we do not deserve to suffer or encounter any obstacle on the road to fulfillment, nor do we wish any desire to remain unfulfilled. Suffering should be foreign to us. Every desire that comes up should find its way to fulfillment, and waves of our individual life should flow in the fullness of cosmic life. And this is the life that we deserve to live. Individual life in eternal freedom of cosmic life. Individual life in the bliss of eternal being, individual life, supplemented and supported by the unlimited force of cosmic life. Be it to us, to our neighbors, and to all the individuals in the world. May God bless every man to turn within himself and tap the unlimited source of power that lies within.